YouTube? Well, the battery desulfator finally got here. Took longer than expected from UK. This is a 12 to 24 volt desulfator. It does up to 500 amp hours. I'm going to test it out on my system since my battery's not in the best shape and see if I can recover them better than what they are. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna do one battery at a time. Then I'll reconnect them all together and leave it on 24/7. So as you can see there, it's 13.28. Right, so it's all hooked up now. And I just put it here for now. So at least it's out of the way. So it's all on and going. And we'll see how it does. So as I said, it's just come off of the charge. So that's how it's going to look for now. This means down to 200 amp hours, so hopefully I can, might have to take some load off at night. I'll do an update and see how that goes. Said batteries are at full. And the other update my other cables came in and now they're all going good, so they're the same cable as what's up here. I just have to plug this other one back in since I took the batteries off. They're not on a disconnect. I plugged all them back in. So as I said, this one's for the inverter. It's what it's using. This is the volts for the wind turbine, and that's one for the wind turbine, and this one is for the panels just above us, and that one is the panels that are on the shed. So I'm going to chuck more load on now. This is what I run on a typical day-to-day base. Sometimes I've had it up close to 300 watts. It's about the maximum I can do, just slightly under 300, maybe about 280 roundabout. And that's what my inverter's chewing at the moment, out of the solar. Not so much the batteries because it's that full. Today's not a cloud in the sky, not a lot of breeze.
There is more content to come, So like it, hate it, subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. I'll catch you all on the next one. Thanks and bye.